Welcome to Spooky Stories to Tell in the Dark. This is the story of Vine 2, how it rode the hype train to the top, and how that train disappeared.
Vine is back.
People calling it Vine 2.
Yeah, Vine 2. Chances are you probably forgot about Vine 2. And that's not a bad thing. Everyone else forgot about it too. But when it was announced, it was massive news. Everyone was talking about it. At this time in YouTube, you couldn't go 2 seconds without running into a Vine compilation in your recommended. So even people who never used Vine were on the hype train for Vine 2. If you weren't excited for Vine 2, fuck you. Then things came to a grinding halt a few months later when Vine 2 was announced to be indefinitely delayed. In 2018, it was official. Vine 2 was announced dead, but in its place, Byte. B-Y-T-E. What a stupid name, but okay. At this point, the community was pretty heavily divided. Many people believed that TikTok was doing a fine job at filling the void Vine left behind, while others were sitting in quiet anticipation for Hoffman's sequel. In 2019, Byte was finally released, and it was not released to negative or positive critical reception. Rather, it was met by no critical reception. No one cared. Yeah, the idea that TikTok had replaced Vine was really controversial a couple years ago. Many people didn't agree. But when Byte finally came out, the consensus had changed. We all sort of understood that, yeah, TikTok, they did it. We don't need another one. And Byte was still here. We had it, and we had nothing to do with it. So knowing that there was this great competition, what did Hoffman do to separate his app from TikTok? At first glance, Byte is very similar to TikTok. And at second glance, it's still very similar to TikTok. No matter how many glances you take, you'll find Byte is essentially just another TikTok. It does have a few new features though, among them are sucking ass, etc. The layout is very similar to TikTok. There's a discover page and a for you page. The for you page is called the Your Mix page, which just feels stupid. Honestly, like I feel like I'm on SoundCloud and not Vine 2. It just sounds dumb. When it comes to the content, Byte shits the bed hard. When signing on to any content-based app, you should be greeted by the cream of the crop. And in Byte, you are, but the cream of the crop just happens to be ass. It feels like most of these jokes and skits are just setups with nothing left. There's also a few weird things about the app, like you can't see how many followers someone has, which makes it a total bust for clout chasers. And you can't see how many likes a video has. It's just stupid. To get to the comments section, you have to click the description, but once you're there, you'll find that the comments have almost everything that the videos are lacking. You can see how many likes they have. You can see when they were posted. Why do the comments have more rights than the video? That doesn't make any sense. The only way I knew that half the videos I was seeing on the For You page were months old is because the comments told me. Byte also has partner creators, and the partner creators are all also big creators on TikTok, which feels kind of sad. Which leads me to believe that Byte slipped them a couple bucks and begged them to make some garbage for their app, and they finally said yes. It doesn't feel good, it doesn't feel inspired, and it's just pathetic. That's like YouTube having to go to Jack Black and say, hey, please, pretty, please stop doing Jumanji and make me a video real quick. It's just sad, like the rest of this app. In conclusion, Hoffman's original creation gave us some of the most influential pieces of art of the 2010s. And Hoffman's latest creation gave us nothing. Vine seemed to end at the perfect time. It lasted long enough to give us plenty of content to enjoy later, but not too long where the format got old and tired. Twitter honestly did the right thing and buried Vine when they had the chance. Instead of letting it rest peacefully, Hoffman grabbed a shovel. I ain't afraid of no ghosts.